Hello everyone. So in last lecture, we discussed one example on dominant pole. In this session, we will discuss a question asked in GATE 2014, IIT Kharagpur, and the question is based on a dominant pole concept and it has three poles. So we will discuss how the concept is used when you have three poles in a transfer function. So the question is, a plant has an open loop transfer function g of s, which is given by 20 upon s plus 0.1 into s plus 2 into s plus 100. The approximate model obtained by retaining only one of the above pole, which is closest to the frequency response of the original transfer function at low frequency, is. So the question says we have to approximate the model of the transfer function by retaining only one of the above pole. Now in the transfer function we have three poles. They are asking to approximate the transfer function to only one pole, and we have to select which of the pole will be the correct answer. Now it further says which is closest to the frequency response of the original transfer function at low frequency is. Now at low frequency, I have already discussed in the concept of dominant pole, when you find the DC gain, it is also called low frequency. Now once you know the concept of three poles in a dominant pole, you will solve this question within 15 to 20 seconds. But first, let us do the analysis of dominant pole concept using three poles. So the given transfer function, as you can see on the screen, we have three poles. The first pole is at minus 0.1, the second pole is at minus 2, and the third pole is at minus 100. So we can plot the poles on the S plane. We have three poles, minus 0.1, minus 2, and minus 100. Now by looking, you will say the 0.1 pole is the dominant pole as it is near to the origin. And yes, you are correct. The 0.1 pole is a dominant pole as it is near to origin. But we will discuss in detail about the rest of the two poles. So these are the three poles that we have plotted on the S plane. Now first, we need to understand the eligibility criteria of a dominant pole, that is the ratio of insignificant pole upon significant pole should be greater than or equal to 5. Now we have three poles. Now whenever you have more than two poles, for example you have three poles or four poles, you can use this method. Now firstly, you should consider only these two poles, the poles which are far from the origin. In this case, the poles are minus 100 and minus 2. For time being, let us not consider this minus 0.1 pole. Let us assume we have only these two poles, minus 100 and minus 2. And if this is the case, we will say this minus 2 pole is a dominant pole, or it is also called significant pole, and minus 100 is your insignificant pole. Again, I am telling you, for time being, I have discarded this minus 0.1 pole. So we have insignificant pole, which is minus 100, and significant pole, minus 2. Now if you put the values 100 by 2, the answer is 50, and yes, 50 is greater than 5. Hence, dominant pole concept is applicable for these two poles, minus 100 and minus 2. Hence, we can neglect the insignificant pole, which is s plus 100, from the transfer function. So now we have removed one pole. Earlier we had three poles. Now by using the concept of dominant pole, we have removed a pole which was at s is equals to minus 100. Now we have left with only two poles, minus 2 and minus 0.1. Again, we need to first check whether the concept of a dominant pole is applicable or not. And we know minus 0.1 is near to the origin. So it is your dominant pole or it is your significant pole. and minus 2 is your insignificant pole. So again, you have to put the values. It is 2 upon 0.1, which will be equal to 20. And yes, 20 is again greater than 5. Hence, dominant pole concept is applicable. And hence, we can neglect the insignificant pole. In this case, it is s plus 2 from the transfer function. So now we have approximated the transfer function to only one pole, and that is s plus 0.1 by using the concept of dominant pole. But as you know, we are not done yet. We need to find the correct approximation of the transfer function. So as discussed in earlier lectures also, you have to first find the DC gain of the original transfer function. You cannot directly cancel s plus 2 and s plus 100 pole directly. First, we need to find the DC gain. So when we substitute s is equals to 0 in the transfer function, you will get 20 upon 0 plus 0.1 into 0 plus 2 into 0 plus 100. So the DC gain will be 1. Hence, the approximated transfer function will be g of s will be 0.1 upon s plus 0.1. This is the dominant pole, s plus 0.1. And we want the DC gain to be 1. The DC gain of the approximated transfer function should be also equal to the DC gain of original transfer function. The DC gain of original transfer function is 1. So the DC gain of approximated transfer function should be also 1. So now if you put the value of s is equals to 0, you will get 0.1 upon 0.1, which will be equal to 1. So the correct approximated transfer function is 0.1 upon s plus 0.1. So this was our original question, and we found the correct answer as option number A, it is 0.1 upon s plus 0.1. So I hope now you have understood how to use the dominant pole concept when you have three poles. So in next lecture, we will discuss some more examples on dominant pole so that you have a clear idea about this concept.